Hi, I'm Rudy. In this video, we'll look at a demonstration of the audio tube preamplifier, which was one of the questions in the final exam of 6002X. In the first part, we'll look at the working of a vacuum tube. As tube applications are rare nowadays, a lot of people haven't seen a tube and don't know how they work. Secondly, we will use a free circuit simulation program, LTSPICE 4, to evaluate the static, dynamic, and frequency response of the circuit. Thirdly, we will build the circuit and make circuit measurements on it. So, how does a vacuum tube, also called electron tube or thermoionic valve, works? Everything is built into a glass tube, which is at the bottom sealed under vacuum, so there is no residual air in it. Inside this glass tube are the different electrodes. We have seen in our schematic that there are three electrodes, for all triode. This is the cathode, the anode, and the grid. The first electrode, the cathode, is a small rectangular or circular tube, which is connected to the negative terminal of the power supply. This negative terminal has an excess of negative electrons, which will tend to escape from the surface of the cathode. To facilitate this electron emission, we will coat it with thorium, strontium, or another metal oxide, and heat it up to about 1000 degrees with a heater filament, which is placed inside this cathode and connected to a supply of 6.3 volts. This can be alternate current or direct current. The second electrode is the anode. This is a plate. This is a metal envelope around the cathode and is connected to the positive terminal of our power supply. If we have enough potential difference between the anode and the cathode, the electrons will leave the surface and go to the positive anode. This effect is discovered at the end of the 19th century by Edison. It's therefore called the Edison effect. But it was until 1904 that Fleming has built the first practical application for this in an electron tube, which was able to rectify currents, because you cannot place a negative voltage on anode and positive on the cathode. There will be no emission because the anode is not heated, and so the current can only flow from one side, from the cathode to the anode inside the tube. To regulate this current, we have a third electrode, the grid, which is a fine wire wound around the cathode and is placed on the slightly negative voltage to the cathode. This negative voltage makes that not all electrons can go to the anode, and the more negative this voltage is, the less electrons will escape the cathode and less current will flow. Above in the tube we have another element. This is the getter. This is a small cup, metal cup, which holds a pellet of barium. And after the manufacturing of the tube, this getter with by induction, so that the barium evaporates, reacts with the residual gases in the tube, and deposits on the glass in the top. And this gives the silvery coating we see on electron tubes. If there is leakage in the tube from air, this barium will get oxidized and will get a white color. And this will indicate a bad lamp. This is the ECC88. It is a double triode valve. You can see here the two separate anodes, so the gray surround metal surfaces here. At the top we can see the getter ring. The metal finish coating here at the inside of the tube is the barium that's deposited into this tube. This tube has been sealed from the top. The base is a novel 9-pin. The first pin is counted from left to right, so this is pin 1, pin 2, pin 3, pin 4, 5, till pin 9. We can better see the electrodes with this old pre-war military tube. This is CB78. We see here in the getter the small barium pellet. I turn that around. So if you look from the top, we see here two small wires from the heater filament. Next to it is the connection for the cathode. The cathode, which is this rectangular tube here. Not so easy to see. Around this cathode is the grid. It's so the wires are so fine we cannot see them, but we can see these two wires here that support this screen, and everything is enveloped with the anode plate here, so this big plate. We can clearly see connection of the electrodes to the base with these wires. This is a big base, so this was made for use in vehicles, because the vibrations tend to make bad connections. This is a socket for the ECC88 tube. At the bottom we see the solder lugs where we can connect the wires to. We still use the 6.3 volt heater voltage, because at the time they used the car batteries voltage to connect to the heater. The tube we used in the circuit was the 6DG8. This is an United States designation. The first letter gives the heater voltage, so 6.3 volt. Only the first digit is given. The two letters that follow have no meaning, and the last digit gives the number of useful elements in the tube. Because it's a double triode, we have two cathodes, two anodes, two grids, a heater, and a shield plate. So a total of 8 elements. In Europe, we use the Mullard-Phillips designation. This ECC88 is compatible with 6DG8, so we can exchange those tubes. The first letter also gives us the heater voltage, which is 6.3 volts. The two letters that follow give the type and usage of the tube. C means a triode, because there are two C's, there are a double triode. And the following number gives the type of socket or base that the lamp uses, so it's a 9-pin Noval socket. There are a lot of other designations, for instance, the military have their own numbering system. So a British military valve is a CV78. CV means common valve. Americans have also their own military designation. Now, for what are vacuum tubes still used? A first application that has still more enthusiasts is the professional audio amplifiers. They are still used because they give a better sound. They give a fuller sound than a solid state amplifier. Even if they cost 3 times the price of a solid-state amplifier, a lot of people still prefer the tube amplifier. One of the reasons is the tube amplifier is simpler, has less components, and therefore has less distortion. Also, the tube amplifier gives second harmonics, which the human ear interprets as a full sound. A solid state amplifier gives more third harmonics, which are colder and harder to the ear.